How to reassign drive letters in Windows. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Drive letters are usually assigned by the operating system whenever you attach or insert a drive. However, most of them can actually be reassigned if you don't happen to like the particular drive letter or if you want to do something else other than what the system has given you. That's true for almost every drive with one exception. Let me show you how it works. So we're over here in Windows 11, and what I'm about to show you actually applies to pretty much every Windows version since at least Windows 7. Fire up the Disk Management tool. I right-clicked on the Start menu here and hit Disk Management, and you'll see that we have two drives. We have two physical drives, one that contains the C partition, and then another one, this second drive, that contains a partition that happens to be labeled or assigned the drive letter E. What if I don't like E? Well, it's actually not that hard to change. All we need to do is right-click on it, click on Change Drive Letters and Paths. Now, you can hit Change, but I believe that that's not always there. So what I'm going to do instead is hit Remove, which will remove that drive letter. Now, all of a sudden, the drive is attached to the system, but it is no longer visible in Windows File Explorer. I'm going to right-click on it again, click on Change Drive Letters and Paths again. This time, I'm clicking on Add. Assign the following drive letter, and of course, it defaults to E, because that was what it defaulted to when it first assigned a drive letter to this drive. However, if we click on the little down arrow, you'll see that we can choose from, well, all sorts of drive letters we might want to use. Now, I'll skip over A and B for a moment, then I'll talk about that in just a bit. Let's just say I always wanted this drive to be drive L. Okay, I'll click on L, hit OK, and sure enough, there it is now as drive L. And in fact, if I fire up Windows File Explorer, you can see I have a local disk C and my second drive as L. That's really all there is to it. Each drive can only be assigned one drive letter at a time, which is fine. The other options that you saw there are more of an advanced topic to assign a path to a drive, but that is something that I do talk about in the article on what happens if you've got too many drives, if you actually run out of drive letters in that drop-down list. Now, I do want to talk briefly about drive A and B. It's one of those common questions about Windows. Why does that exist? Why do we start with C, and why don't we start with A? It actually has to do with floppy disks and when Windows' predecessor, Microsoft's MS-DOS, was created. At that time, the system usually used only floppy disks, and in fact, it used two floppy disks. They were assigned the drive letters A and B. When hard disks came along, well, the next available drive letter was C. So that's where hard disks went. C is what Windows would then be installed on machines that happen to have floppy disks. It's the default drive for Windows installations. So over time, floppy disks went away. So A and B are no longer used, but because Windows has been getting installed on the C drive for so long, and because so many applications and perhaps even pieces of Windows itself have made the assumption that Windows is installed on C, they just decided not to change anything. They just removed the drives A and B from being used by default when there is no floppy disk. What that means for you and me is that, well, yeah, if you want to, and the reason I came back to it, is you can in fact assign A and B to any of the drives that you feel like assigning it to. So what I've done now is I've assigned the drive letter A colon to my second drive. And sure enough, it comes up as drive A. If I fire up Windows File Explorer, now I see that I've got the second drive, A, and my hard disk originally, C. That's really all there is to it. Now, there is one last thing to point out. Remember I said that because so many systems, including perhaps pieces of Windows itself, rely on Windows being installed on the C drive? That's one that, while technically you might be able to change, my suspicion is you would get permission denied in the scenario that I just ran through because it's in use and you can't change the drive letter of a drive that's in use. But even if you did manage to change the drive from C to something else, my guess is many, many things would break. So my recommendation is that, yeah, go forth and change the drive letters for whatever you want to change, as long as you don't want to change C. For updates, for related links, for comments, and more, visit askleo.com/2743. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.